Good day, human Latiosites! This is Latios Azubril, and welcome to Let's Play Pokemon Ultra Sun Island Mock! So, here we see, oh my goodness, the Surfing Pikachu and a Mantine. Oh my god, I love how they're going all out with Mantine here. Mantine is such an awesome Pokemon, I'm glad to see it's getting some spotlight here. That said, let's get going. So, let's begin the game. Oh my goodness, this is so exciting. Look, the Pikachu's riding the wave! Settings have been saved. We're getting a message from the Alola region's own Professor Kukui! Alright, let's go answer it. Hang on now. Give me just a sec. Hey there. Good afternoon. So, the day has finally come that you're moving to Alola. Alola is a region made up of several islands. That could be the reason the region is chock full of nothing but rare Pokemon, yeah. There's no shortage of cool Pokemon out here in Alola either. Such mysterious creatures. Aw, it's a little Rockruff. You find them all over, in the grass, in the caves, in the sky, and sea. Here in Alola, we love our Pokemon, and we depend on them heaps, too. Some of us even battle with them, if we call ourselves Pokemon trainers. Rockruff, Cutiefly, I'll play with you later, so cool your jets. Aw. Alright, I gotta ask you some questions about yourself so I can introduce you to everybody. So, which photo should I use for your trainer passport? Alright. So, I feel like that's blonde, although it looks kind of brownish. My hair is brown, so I'll go with the darker one. We can always probably change it as we go on, as with other trainer customizable games. So, let's do this. Alright then, I'll let you spell out your name for me. Alright. We're not gonna fit Latios Azubril, but that's okay. I am perfectly fine with using Eric. Alright. He asked for my name, so there we go. Four, good buddy. I'll let everybody out here know you're on your way. Eric. Oh, it's a Bricky Pick too. Yeah, that's a name that hits you like a drop kick right to the head. Woo! Can't wait to see you in person then, cousin. Alright, bye.
Eric, come help with the boxes.
Sure, why not? Okay. Well then. Alright, we've got a little chase sequence, it looks like, going on Aether Paradise. Alright. Yeah, I see Nebby. Okay. That's different. Well then. That definitely just happened. So, welcome to Pokemon Ultra Sun! Alright. That definitely was a new twist on there, 3 months later. Okay. Fair enough. It'll probably be another 3 months before we end up getting our starters, but you know, whatever. Our starter. Alright. So it's the same house, so it looks a little different. Also, I see that kid running after a Lumiath. Oh, it's a Wingull! Oh, I love the attention to detail here. So I guess we officially retconned our Pokemon Sun Island mock adventure, considering that this is basically a different world. Can't you just feel that warmth? The first day spent under Alola's sun. It's so warm and bright here. But that's enough of that. Time to unpack all these boxes. Yeah, these boxes are never getting unpacked. Meowth, go get Eric for me, would you? Meow! Alright, sure, why not? Oh, was that a Poliwhirl, rug? Oh my goodness. Snorlax doll. What is that? Looks like a picture with some kind of scribble on it. I don't even know. Oh, we have a Pikachu doll right behind us on the bed. And there we are. Yeah, this is definitely a Poliwhirl rug. Cool. You know, fun fact, Poliwhirl was actually one of my favorite Pokemon from Gen 1. I mean, it's not one I use that often. And yeah, I actually like Poliwhirl more than Poliwrath. Politoed summons the rains, I don't know about that. And also, it looks like we have the pincer-designed bed. I guess that's a thing. Alright, let's go get up. Or just, you know, lay down. The scent is somehow oddly comforting. Alright, fair enough. Alright, check the book our father gave us! Okay, menu stuff. Cool. Oh, we can't sit down? Even on a tiny globe like this one, Kanto and Alola seem awfully far apart. Well then, it's the autograph you got from a gym leader in Kanto. Okay, who? They wrote, good luck! Yeah, I can't tell who. Alright, they're showing a movie on TV. The scene is showing four boys walking down a set of railroad tracks, but it's time to get going. Fair enough. It's a game console you can even take outside and play. They're really pushing out that Switch. Oh my goodness. That is definitely it. I think it even says Switch on it. It's a Snorlax cushion. It's said to be ruinously comfy, that you could waste away your whole life lazing about on one. That is incredible detail. Probably too much detail. It's a new coat rack your mom bought for you. Cool. And I'm somehow back in bed. I didn't mean to do that. Whatever. Alright, Meowth. I got the message. Let's go. Alright. You were out like a light, weren't you? You ought to be full of energy by now, and just look! It's already daytime here! It's completely the opposite of Kanto. But then, we are so far away here in Alola. So, Eric, are you excited to meet some Alolan Pokemon? Sure, of course. That's right, I want you to hurry up and meet some too. Or I guess you would too as well. We're living in the Alola region now, the beautiful islands everyone wants to visit. I'm sure the Pokemon living in a place like this must be friendly, right? It might not be a bad idea to just go out and see for yourself just how friendly Pokemon here are. You're probably gonna get attacked by one. Right, Eric? Go and get ready for a bit of exploring. Your bag and hat and things should be hanging on your coat rack in your room. And didn't you leave your copy of Adventure Rules in your desk, too? Yeah, we don't need a coat. I guess we do need our bag and our hat. Okay, fine. Fine. We're not allowed to just, you know... You know what? At least they're not making us go running around in our drawers. Alright, so, Let's go put on our, I guess, bag and hat. Not exactly the X and Y with our clothes, but since we're already dressed, and thank goodness for that. Alright. Okay. I guess Meowth just said a joke. Oh, wait a minute, this Meowth can't talk. Now you look ready for anything. Oh, but even so, Eric, try to be careful walking through the tall grass. Still, I have to admit that I'd love to have a new Pokemon around.
why don't you head up toward Icky Town and see what you discover in Alola? You know what, since there's a Meowth here, why don't I go with a Meowth, just to be safe? Or not? Okay. Alright, see ya, Meowth. So, this is a, not much here. And really not much to talk to, either. Wow. Okay, well then, let's, a new fridge bought right here in Alola. Fair enough. Let's go on an adventure. Clearly it's our house, not our mother's house, considering our name's on the mailbox. It's your dad's car. Mom brought it along so she could use it and to go out and run errands. She doesn't have a job? It's your mom's beloved surfboard. She brought it all the way to from Kanto with her. So she's from around Fuchsia? Hmm. Oh, hey, Lingle. Well, I mean, the thing is, oh, we could still do that. Ha. Why is there all of Dad's stuff, but no Dad? Weird. Watch it, cuz it's dangerous to get too close to a Pokemon while it's using one of its moves. Roof! Alright, I guess we can't go that way. Well then. That didn't work out quite well. Alright, blockades and stuff. Okay. You can go with me if you dash with B. What do you think of my song? Did that Meowth just hiss at us? That happened. Route 1 proper. Okay. Hey there. The power of science is amazing! You can enjoy a festival with people from around the world without taking a step! Every day is a festival when you can do that! With the power of science! Cool. I love the attention to detail here. Something is coming at you from the tall grass. Okay. It's a young goose! Do I have to kick this thing? Because I don't really want to do that. I'm again. Oh no, hey! The cavalry is here! Oh, oh my god, that is so adorable. Yah yah! Alright. Just scared. Alright, 3 against 1. I guess that makes sense. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, they're so adorable. Hey there, cousin. Hang on, I know you. You're Eric, right? You okay? Saw you get attacked like that. I wasn't scared. Yeah, I could buy with a little help from my friends, I guess. Alright. Looks like you did, though I sure didn't expect that, yeah? I didn't think these little fellows would dash out on their own to help save a stranger, but I guess I'm getting ahead of myself. Welcome to Alola, the Pokemon Paradise. That's what I'm supposed to be saying. I'm Kukui, yeah? The Pokemon Professor! People and Pokemon live and work together here in Alola, too. Don't you ever forget. You can go anywhere, yeah, as long as you got Pokemon in your corner. While Pokemon can be lurking in the tall grass, yeah, just waiting to leap out and bite you, but you'll be fine if you've got a partner of your own. And potentially a tetanus shot. Hey there. Here, let me introduce the Pokemon that helped you just now. By all means. This is the grass-type Pokemon, Rowlet. So cute. And the fire type Pokemon, Litten! Aww. and the water type Pokemon Popplio! Oh, so adorable. You see, the fact of the matter is, one of these Pokemon will become your first partner. Heh, maybe that's why they wanted to save you. Go on and choose the one you'd like to keep as your partner, cousin. Alright, so I guess we have a decision to make. Go ahead and choose which we are picking as our partner. Are we gonna pick Rowlet, Litten, or Popplio? Now, in Pokemon Sun, we chose Rowlet. I do not regret that. I love Rowlet. It is one of my 5 all-time favorite Pokemon. My second favorite of the 3 is Popplio. It is such an adorable Pokemon. Popplio is probably my favorite of all of the starters that are not my favorite of their generation. I just love Popplio so much. It is such an adorable Pokemon. Such a cool Pokemon. Plus, it's a special attacker with a special stab. Actually, 2 special stabs. Although then again, I guess there are physical water moves because we do have a physical special split. But still, that's still a useful thing nonetheless. Litten, if I ever picked a Litten, I would never evolve it, or at least maybe a Torracat, but definitely not Incineroar. I'm not a huge fan of Incineroar, but I love Litten, don't get me wrong. But I'm not gonna pick Litten. Last time I did pick Rowlet, so, I mean, I could go with Popplio, but honestly, I love Rowlet too much. I gotta go Rowlet. Rowlet can fly up on its enemies real quiet, like, yeah, and catch them by surprise. So you want to go with the grass-type Pokemon, Rowlet? Yes, I do. I definitely do. I know variety is a good thing, but honestly, I can't not pick Rowlet. So with that, we chose Rowlet. Alright. So, we want to give a nickname? Sure. You're not shiny, but I'm okay with that. You are male. Give you a name. I can't name you Oliver. I've done that. Too obvious a name as well. I feel like any name I pick is going to be too obvious because, come on. But I've already named one Oliver, so you shall be Robin. So Robin was added to the party. You went with Rowlet. Whew, what a fine-looking team you two are. Now that you can have Pokemon battles, you're what we call a Pokemon trainer. Well, you know what? I guess shiny hunting this would be a lot easier than in Sun and Moon with this for the starters, considering it's a lot shorter of a cutscene. You don't have to go through that whole thing with Tapu Koko and whatnot. Here's a Pokeball for Rowlet, too. Get you feel nice and cozy in there. Unless Rowlet wants to, you know... If Rowlet wants to just travel on my shoulder, I'm okay with it. Alright, then let's get going up to Eeky Town, Eric. Woo! Time to meet the Island Kahuna! Island Kahuna? Truth is, that partner Rowlet of yours is a gift from the Kahuna, not me. So let's go show it off and say a proper thank you, cousin. It may not be the only gift you get. In case you hadn't heard, the Kahunas are all crazy strong Pokemon trainers. Be careful about getting into a battle with one. Fair enough. Alright. Eeky Town is right up here. Okay. Get Rowlet there in the Pokeball I gave you. Really? Okay, I'm sorry, Rowlet. I'm sorry. I really hope we don't run into a shiny. That would really suck. before we get Pokeballs, that is. Oh, hey, it's that young goose. Young goose, prepare to get attacked! We're just gonna throw some leaves at you. This is just huge. This is maximum leafage. Maximum leafage. Take the hit! Get wrecked. Alright. So, now, this is of course an Island Mach, which is not a Nuzlocke. I clearly forgot to go through the rules of the Island Mach before. Basically, every time we get to a new island, our team pretty much changes. It's that simple as we go through our island challenge. So basically, you guys pick the type that we use for that for our team. So basically what's going to happen is, on each island, we have up to six Pokemon on our team. The first Pokemon is our starter. Our starter can always be in our team. Nothing against that. Second Pokemon can be any type, any Pokemon that we want. There is no rule against anything. Whatever we want as our second Pokemon. Obviously not something that's like extremely overleveled, but I mean, I guess if we have it legally, it's fine. But the other Pokemon on our team, there's no restriction on which Pokemon in a route we can catch. It's not like a Nuzlocke in that respect. There's no restriction on how many Pokemon from each area we can catch. There's no Pokemon dying. The other four Pokemon must be of a given type that we choose ahead of time. So we're going to choose a type for that island. And that means on that island, our team, the back four Pokemon on our team must be of that type. Even if it's the same type as our starter. So if it's a grass or flying type Pokemon, if it's grass or flying as that type, the other four Pokemon still need to be grass or flying. Our starter does not count in that, in there. Now there's no death happening, so our starter never really is going to leave the team. Speaking of our starter, let's go see Robin's nature. Huh, that's actually, I mean, careful's not bad for a Rowlet. I mean, we're not going to get many special moves anyway, so, I mean, it's a physical attacker. I would have preferred an adamant nature, but whatever. I will take it. I will definitely take it. Oh my goodness. It's a cute Pokemon, and Robin might never evolve. I don't know. It depends on what happens. I really don't care all that much about that. Oh, Pokemon Refresh, okay. Okay, Robin. I know how Pokemon Refresh works. You don't have to do that. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, this is so adorable! Oh, you don't like that? Okay, that's fine. That's fine. So, the Island Mach is not as challenging as a Nuzlocke. I understand that. We're trying to just have some fun here. It's just, like, something a little different. So, that's a happy Rowlet. There you go. Alright, I don't think you're gonna give any more hearts right now. Yeah, alright, whatever. Okay. Let's go. Oh my goodness. Alright, that said, I think we have things to do. There's a Pokeball right here, which means I must pick it up, because it's a potion! We got a potion, yeah. Alright! Oh hey! How's it going? Nice to meet you. Hey! Yeah, how's it going? Which Pokemon are you going to choose your partner? Have you decided? Dude, we haven't met. Oh yeah, I'm Hal. I couldn't wait for us to pick up our partners together, so I came to find you myself.
Yeah, I already picked my Pokemon. I guess Rowlet doesn't like the ball. I'm okay with that.
Whoa, your Rowlet is so cute, so cool. Hey, wait, you already picked a Pokemon.
Sorry about that, Hal. We had a little accident on the way here, so I ended up letting Eric choose partner first without you.
Fair enough. I guess it was just fate for you guys to meet.
But you can choose one of these two, Hal.
You know, of the two, Hal, I would pick Popplio. I would definitely pick Popplio. And I'm not saying that because I'd have a type advantage over you.
My partner will be Popplio. I choose you!
Smart move, Hal. Smart move.
Alola, friend! I decided ages ago that you're the one I wanted to have an adventure with.
I'm glad you didn't want Rowlet, because that makes it a lot easier for us. This way we don't have to worry about having, you know, a competition between who deserves Rowlet.
We're gonna do so much awesome stuff together! Just you wait and see!
How are you trying to make me jealous? I mean, I'm still not regretting my decision to pick Rowlet, but oh my goodness, Popplio is so cute!
Why do all the starters have to be so good?
Professor, you'll take good care of Litten, right?
You better believe I will, Hal.
Yeah.
Alright then, Litten, everybody, time to get back in your balls for now.
Wait up, me and Popplio have a favor to ask. We are opponents in our first ever Pokemon battle together.
Sure, but you're not my first Pokemon battle.
What if I just said no?
Hold on, before you two step into the ring, let's make sure little Rowlet is up to it.
Oh, you're gonna heal me? Okay, fair enough. I mean, that Yonkus didn't do any damage whatsoever, but whatever.
Alright, I'm seriously gonna enjoy this!
Alright, here we go in our first battle with a Pokemon Trainer. Alright, we're challenged by Pokemon Trainer Hal. Alright, he is leading. He's just got the Popplio, so we're good. We have the type advantage. And we have the leafage, so he doesn't really have a chance in, he doesn't have a chance. Oh, he's got a female. Interesting. He really doesn't have a chance. You gotta grab a water gun. I mean, I understand it's stab, but I think he got a crit. That was a crit? I only did 4 damage. I actually feel bad about destroying this thing with leafage. Okay, I'm sorry I had to go this way. I'm sorry. Alright, well, Robin grew to level 6. And with that, we defeated Pokemon Trainer Hal. Our first defeat. Sorry, Popplio. You're only giving us 100, really? No, you must be poor. I thought your grandfather was like the Kahuna or something.
Whoa! That was awesome, Eric! You and Rowlet were both so cool!
Oh my goodness! You've got to have the kind of battles where everyone has fun. You and your partner Pokemon too, you know.
Right on, Eric. You and Hal both brought out the best in your partners and pulled off some spectacular moves, yeah. Ikitown is right up those stairs. Come on, Eric.
You should totally check out Ikitown.
Alright, sure, why not? To Ikitown we go.
Okay. And we're here. This right here is Ikitown. Cool.
This town is where folks come to worship the Pokemon that watches over Melly Melly Island. Tapu Koko keeps us all safe and happy, see? Looks like the Kahuna is nowhere to be found, though. I guess there must be some trouble somewhere on the island that needs fixing, yeah?
Yeah, and the Kahuna wandered off without a word to anybody, singing a little ditty or something.
I'm gonna go stop by home for a sec. I've got to show my mom, Popplio.
Oh, you have a mother. Wonder who your father is.
Hey, I've got an idea for you, Eric. If you head through the village and up the hill, you can get to the ruins that belong to Tapu Koko. That's our island's guardian deity, yeah? Why don't you go and introduce yourself? If you're real lucky, maybe you'll actually get a glimpse of the guardian deity yourself. I'll stick around here and wait to see if the kahuna comes back.
Well, I feel like that could be a little dangerous considering, you know, bothering a guardian deity? What could possibly go wrong?
Kahuna Hala is the strongest Pokemon trainer in all of Meli Meli. There must be some trouble going down somewhere on the island that needs your kahuna's touch, because he said something about how it's time for old Hala and went off somewhere.
Ah, well then. Okay, the ruins of conflict. Okay, let's go. Mahalo Trail. Going to pay respects to the guardian deity? It's a fickle one, but I hope you meet it. As long as it doesn't kill me, we'll be good. Oh my goodness. Alright. Oh, hey! Hey there!
I know, I'll take you to the ruins. So please stay in the bag. We could get in trouble if anyone sees you.
Yes, Nebby, stay in the bag. Well then. She seems out of breath. Nebby, what are you doing? Nebby, get in the bag! Nebby, get in the bag. Well then. That is not something new. It's obviously Nebby gets attacked by Spearow, because why wouldn't Nebby get attacked by Spearow? Hi there. Ah. I know what's wrong, and I think I know who you are, so... Help! Save Nebby!
Phew!
Oh, poor Nebby.
The Spearow were attacking it, but I'm not a trainer. I can't... Please, please save Nebby. I'll heal your Pokemon for you, so...
Okay, well... Do we have to battle a bunch of Spearow then? Or are we gonna fall to our death? Whoa! Spearow attacking. A wild Spearow attacked. Okay. Yeah, we are so destroying this bridge right now. We are definitely about to destroy this bridge. Pursuit, you're actually... I don't have any other Pokemon. How are you... And you got a crit, too. Robin, are you like a crit magnet or something? Why do Pokemon keep critting you? Another thing, just reading to us. Reading to us until we feel defenseless. That's like better on a pack. Stop reading! Alright. So... Minus 2 defense, doesn't even matter, you're going down. 3-hit KO. Robin gained 32 experience points and grew to level 7! Oh, Robin, so proud of you! Aw.
You managed to chase off one of the Spearow, but... Oh, but there are still more! Please, please help Nebby if you can, but be careful, it looks like that attack may have damaged the plank bridge too.
Oh great, yeah, we just destroyed the bridge. Oh god, we're about to fall to our death, aren't we? But you know what? We gotta save Nebby. Whoa. Yeah, we gotta save Nebby. We're gonna fall to our death, but we gotta. Don't worry, Nebby, I got you. I don't know who's got me, but, you know, I've got you. Nebby, that is not a good idea. What the? Goodbye, sweet world. What the? Oh my god. Did Tapu Koko just, like, kill the Spearow? It's a bird! It's a plane! No, it's a Pokemon. Alright. So. Wow, that happened. Pew!
Oh, thank goodness! You tried using your power again, didn't you? Oh, Nebby, you know what happened last time you used. You couldn't move for ages after that. I don't want to see you like that again. No, I shouldn't say that. I'm sorry, Nebby. I know you were trying to save me that time, and I couldn't even help you in return. Pew! What? What's that? Pew pew! Sparkling stone? Feels almost warm somehow. Please forgive me. I am so grateful to you for helping us out of that dangerous spot.
Okay.
I'm Lily, and I suppose this stone must belong to you.
At least she's not trying to hide who she is. They obtained the sparkling stone!
Please, don't tell anyone about this. About seeing Nebby. It's a secret, okay? Come on. Get in the bag, Nebby.
Phew! Nebby, you heard her. Get in the bag. Poor Nebby.
I'm worried we might get attacked again by some wild Pokemon or something. I know it's too much for me to ask it, but do you think you could see us back to town?
Whoa. Oh my goodness, you can actually... You actually can, still, like, trip over, but you can't actually fall. I guess it makes sense. Kind of suck if the main character can actually die in the Pokemon game. Although that would make it very interesting if you actually went from your island challenge to Ghost. But, you know, who knows, maybe one day they'll actually make it so you can actually die in a Pokemon game and then go through your journey as a Ghost. I don't think they'll ever actually do that, and I kind of hope they don't. Alright.
Oh, Eric, you already met Lily, huh? She's my assistant, yeah.
Cool.
Lily, I thought you were with the Kahuna.
Kahuna Hala? He said that he had something to attend to, so he left town on his own. I was just taking a little stroll up Mahalo Trail while I waited for him to return.
And that's how you met our new neighbor, Eric, huh? He just got to Alola yesterday, helped him find his way around, yeah?
So, you're also one of the professor's acquaintances? Nice to meet you.
The Kahuna is back! Kahuna Hala has returned!
Our guardian chosen one is back.
Only one of the strongest Pokemon users in Alola, yeah! Have I missed something?
There you are, Kahuna Hala. Was there some kind of trouble?
Just got caught up in the middle of some brawling Rockruff, that's all. Sorry, Lily. What were you saying before? For some reason, I thought I saw Tapu Koko flying about.
Yes. Kahuna Hala, Nebby got attacked by some Spearow on the Plank Bridge, and Eric here helped protect it. But the bridge collapsed, and I thought both of them might fall to the bottom of the ravine. And that was when the island's guardian deity swooped in to save them.
Woo! That's something you don't hear every day. Although it is said to protect us, our Tapu Koko is a rather fickle creature. yet our guardian was moved to save you. Kukui, my boy, I think we have cause to celebrate! Looks like we have a brave and kind new Pokemon trainer in our midst. I'm glad to meet you, child. I am Hala, the Kahuna of Mele Mele Island. Welcome to Alola, young Alola. Young Kukui had told me of your coming. I'm glad we got the chance to meet today. Phew!
Oh, when did you get out again? I know the Kahuna Hala and the professor will keep you safe from any harm, but you should still stay in the bag and out of sight. It's safer that way. Nebby, well, seems to have taken a liking to you. I have to read that Pokemon, I have read that Pokemon like it when you pet them or take care of them, you know?
Alright, here's a lovely gift from me to help make today special, Eric. With that, we obtained a Pokedex! A Pokedex is a real high-tech kind of tool, yeah, that can automatically record facts about any Pokemon that you meet. Your new partner, Rowlet, is already registered. Oh yeah, so check it out. Alright, and this is a trainer passport that I had put together for you. Well, you gotta meet the Kahuna at least. Ready to head home now, Eric?
Sure, why not? I really appreciate what you did for us on the Plank Bridge. I won't forget you and Rowlet.
Okay.
I mean, I wouldn't forget Rowlet either.
If you two can work in harmony with each other, you can go anywhere together. Now that you met Tapu Koko, I can't wait to see how far you can go as a Pokemon trainer, yeah.
Oh yeah, Eric, hold up a sec!
What is it, Hal? Did you forget something?
You're seriously asking me that? Who's the one here who forgot to tell him before wandering off for a little short stroll and a sing without a word, huh?
Eric, would you be so kind as to give me a look at that sparkling stone you have there?
Sure, why not?
Could it be? Choo-choo, isn't that... You were rescued by Tapu Koko at the bridge. Isn't that what I heard, Eric?
Yeah.
So it even deigned to give you a stone. Perhaps you are here in Alola, Eric, because this is where you are meant to be. Allow me to borrow this stone for now. Fret not, I'll return it to you tomorrow evening.
You have the makings of a brilliant trainer. I can see the light within you, too.
You must do us the honor of joining in our festival tomorrow. First, I'll make sure you get back home safe today, though, Eric. Lily, you two should come with us, too, yeah? Wouldn't want to go losing it twice in one day. You are that precious Pokemon of yours.
Yes, I will keep an eye on...
Nebby? Really?
Phew! Oh, you, would you not try to escape in the very moment that you were told to not wander off?
Poor Nebby. Alright. Back home.
Welcome back, Eric. So, what did you think of Kahuna Hala? Oh, and look who you've got with you. Came running out to help you? What a sweet little thing.
Yeah, that's right.
And it saved you. That's amazing. It must have been fate that you met. The two of you look great together. I feel happier just knowing it, just looking at the pair of you.
I guess Meowth likes. I guess Meowth and Robin like each other.
The next day.
What a stunning sunset. Alright, today's the day that I finally unpack. You still haven't unpacked? Was that the doorbell? Go see who it is, Eric.
See who it is. Sure, why not? We shall find out who it is. What just happened? What? Oh my goodness, it looked like something fell from Meowth's hand. You obtained an awakening. Oh my goodness! That is adorable. It gave you an awakening when you fall asleep in bed. That is hilarious. Either that's rare, or it only happens once. I'm gonna assume the latter, but oh my goodness, that is actually awesome. Oh my goodness. Well. So. I guess next time we're gonna find out who is at the door, and then head out to that festival. So. Today, I'm going to ask you guys to answer a question for me. Which type of Pokemon should we use for each island? So basically, I'm asking you all for all of it right now, just so I have it right off the bat. So which type should I use in for Melimeli Island? Keep in mind that we're probably going to be a lot more limited early on with what type of Pokemon we have available, so probably something along the lines of, like, normal, possibly flying. Because there aren't going to be a whole, maybe water, because there aren't a whole lot of Pokemon, but like a variety of Pokemon types available. If you really need to pick bug, I mean, it's an option, but that could be that could make things a lot more difficult for me. But hey, you know, your choice. I mean, we all have to use revives and whatnot since it's not a Nuzlocke. So which type should we use for Melimeli? Which type should we use for Akala Island? Which type should we use for Ulaula Island? And which type should we use for Pony Island? So be sure to tell me in the comments below so you guys get to be part of the of this experience, because this is our adventure, not just mine. So thank you for watching. As always, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time as we continue our adventure here in Let's Play Pokemon Ultra Sun Island Mach. Goodbye.